we are not afraid. Although we know there's much to fear, we were moving mountains long before we knew we could.
Cancer, in its many forms, continues to be one of the great menaces to human life. Yet the millions who suffer from cancer and other devastating diseases have powerful allies in the fight to regain their health. These are the dedicated scientists and physicians of City of Hope Cancer Center. With each new discovery, City of Hope's scientists come closer to unraveling the mysteries of cancer and other life-threatening diseases. As our research and treatments become the standard of care throughout the world, offering hope to millions of individual lives. Lives like Lacey Conlan's.
When Lacey was 14 months old, we had the opportunity to adopt her. It was just an absolute blessing, a wonderful addition to our family. She was just this sweet, spunky, darling little girl that just lit up our life.
Without warning, 12-year-old Lacey began to suffer periodic headaches and occasional nausea.
Getting sick was kind of a surprise to myself and my family because I didn't usually get sick before. My first symptoms were double vision, like I'd be at school and the blackboard I would see double or blurry.
There was no doubt in our mind she'd have to have glasses if she was seeing double. And my biggest fear was that she'd want purple glasses with rhinestones on them.
But the optometrist couldn't fit glasses. Instead, he identified a swollen optic nerve and referred the Conlans to a neurologist. Within 3 days, Lacey underwent surgery to remove a brain tumor.
We went from this happy girl dancing around singing to her laying in bed with a big scar on her head after having brain surgery and being told that she probably was going to die.
You'd wake up every morning for a split second thinking it was all a dream. And then reality would hit you.
Fortunately, a friend of the Conlans suggested City of Hope Cancer Center. Because of revolutionary research and innovative therapies, often unavailable at other hospitals, City of Hope is able to double Lacey's estimated odds of survival.
To go from hearing that your child maybe has a 30% chance to live, 60, which to a lot of people doesn't sound that great, but to us, I mean, you just grab every ounce of hope that you can.
Dr. Michael Jensen is Lacey's pediatric oncologist at City of Hope.
Lacey suffers from a highly malignant form of brain cancer. Based on her initial responses to chemotherapy and radiation therapy, her prognosis looks good, but there's no known cure for relapse. Diseases like Lacey's claim the lives of too many children, and that's why there's such urgency in our research efforts to develop revolutionary new treatments.
There's nothing harder in this world to accept than a child with cancer.
I don't ever want to see any other parents go through what we've gone through, or any other child. It just breaks my heart.
I just feel that we've got the best team, and I have absolutely the utmost confidence that that if Lacey has a chance, it's with the City of Hope.
We just know that she's going to make it. She's going to get through this. She has to.
The spirit of giving runs strong in the Conlan family.
They were giving me my daughter back. And I had to do something. And I sent out, I think about close to 300 letters to just absolutely everybody we know. Many just started pouring in. from everywhere.
City of Hope spends $1.7 million each week on research and conducts up to 400 trials at a time in an aggressive battle against cancer and other deadly diseases. City of Hope depends on generous giving, not only by those who have suffered from cancer, like Lacey and her parents, but by all who believe in life, in healing, and in the miracle of hope.
I will live the rest of my life with the City of Hope. They're just a wonderful, wonderful place. Not just all of the people and the support we get, but the research and just everything that they're doing. It just gives you hope. When you've given up all hope, they give it right back to you.
Hope to me means never giving up, and there's always a chance, no matter what anybody says. Believe in yourself and you can get through anything. That's my definition of hope.